guys. This is Late Night. We hope we're doing well tonight. And now, if you don't mind, we're going to get to the news. Roughly 100 Trump supporters gathered outside of Palm Beach International Airport this week to protest President Biden's arrival. Oh, come on. The man's 81. He should be getting a hero's welcome in Palm Beach. Should be like when Free Willy finally goes home. The House yesterday passed the Tax Relief for American Families and Workers Act in a bipartisan vote. Wait a minute, Congress still passes legislation? This is like finding out Billy Joel has a new song out. He does? When asked yesterday about the recent pictures showing red marks on his hands, former President Trump said that he had not seen the photographs and added, quote, maybe it's AI. Okay. Who taught him that? Because now that's going to be his answer for everything. AI. That's AI. AI. Me and Jeffrey Epstein. AI. You can't, AI can't fake that kind of friendship. President Biden's campaign attacked former President Trump yesterday in a post on Truth Social. Wow. They went after Trump on his app. That's like telling your teenage daughter she's grounded in a TikTok. Pennsylvania Senator John Fetterman attended the Washington Press Club congressional dinner yesterday wearing shorts and a tuxedo hoodie, and even that was a rental. Oh, I don't actually own anything this fancy. I haven't seen an outfit like that since the time I was a little kid and our uncle had to stay with us for a while. Let's see how many more of these I can do. He looks like someone typed Shrek Wedding into an AI generator. He looks like he buys his suits at Hugh Joe Boss. He looks like a second-tier wrestler named the Mater D. He looks like Adam Sandler's butler. He looks like he's on his way to find the Zoltar machine from Big so he can get his original body back. All right, that's more than enough of that. Let's get to the serious stuff, and thank you. Thank you for having a little bit of fun out of D.C. Before the bipartisan tax bill passed yesterday, Republican Senator Chuck Grassley said that he did not support the legislation because it could make President Biden look good. And Grassley does not like being shown up by the younger generation. South Dakota Governor Kristi Noem said yesterday that her administration is considering sending razor wire and security personnel to Texas to help deter border crossings. Now's our chance, said North Dakota. A Philadelphia woman was arrested on a Frontier Airlines flight after she allegedly pulled down her pants in an attempt to urinate in the aisle. And because of the arrest, Frontier is demoting her to co-pilot. A 3-year-old boy in Australia was recently rescued from a Hello Kitty claw machine, but it took like an entire roll of quarters. The New York Mets have announced that for the first half of the season, Saturday day games will start at 1:40 p.m. in an effort to bring more families and large groups to the ballpark. Well, I guess that's easier than being good at baseball. The CEO of clothing brand H&M stepped down yesterday from her role, and it's not the first time something at H&M wasn't a good fit. Oh, I guess everybody here is perfectly sized. And finally, according to a new survey, 10% of Americans 65 and older have used TikTok. Of course, most of them think this is TikTok. That was a monologue, everybody. We are off and running.